Hi everyone, my name is Michelle and today we're going to quickly discuss the Azure App Service file system, specifically temporary storage. So there's three different types of files within Azure App Services, the same as with any other computer: persisted, temporary, and machine level read-only. We're focusing on these temporary files over here, which are those files that are recycled or deleted whenever you go to restart or recycle your process. These files are going to be stored within the local directory of your file structure in either the app data or temp folders. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, why does this matter to me at all? Well, if we go ahead and move over to the portal over here, you'll see that I'm on a normal app service. Say that your site is suffering from some poor performance and you want to troubleshoot what exactly could be causing that. We can go ahead and move over to the quotas blade within the web app, and here you'll see a report of all of the file system storage within your app service plan. Say that this is at 80% or above, your performance is going to suffer. However, temporary storage has a different limit than your overall app service plan file system storage. As such, you will not be able to see this from the quota blade. So, what if your quotas blade is reporting a low amount of file consumption, but your site still has poor performance? This can still be related to file quota, but we need to check on that somewhere else. To confirm that this is temporary storage, we can go ahead and navigate back to the overview and just restart the site. Because what did we say? We said that the temporary storage folders will empty whenever you go to recycle your process or restart it. Then what you would be able to do is navigate to your site and see the performance improve. Another way to further verify that this is temporary storage would be to navigate to the portal again and go to your Diagnose and Solve Problems blade. Here, we can enter into the best practices for availability and performance detector. Now we see a way, once it loads, to go ahead and monitor our temporary storage usage specifically, right over here. So once confirmed to be an issue, what can we do about it? How can we determine, oh, this is what I need to fix in my code in order to solve that problem? What we can do is we can go ahead and navigate to the Kudu of our site. If you're unfamiliar with Kudu, it is the normal URL of your site with the SCM in between the web app name and the Azure websites component of the URL. Here, you will instantly see it defines your temporary storage folder location within the local directory within the temp folder. We can even see the exact amount being taken up by temporary storage if we navigate into the environment tab. But how can you browse to that folder and see what's inside of it? Well, we can go ahead and navigate to the debug console, which will take you to your file directory. However, you'll notice that you instantly enter the home directory and you can't go back anymore to enter the local directory. This is because the Kudu for your app service is actually running on a separate process than the web app itself. So you cannot see the temporary file storage from this view. However, there is a way to fix that. What we can do is we can go ahead and add this setting to our app settings in the portal. In order to do that, we would go back to the web app in portal, go over to configuration, once it loads, there we go, and then right here we have our app settings. So now we can add the setting that combines the file system for Kudu and the normal sites that we're able to see that, adding it right here, within the diagnostic console over here. I do want to point out, however, that this is a legacy or unsupported setting, but for troubleshooting purposes, we will be adding it. After this issue was solved, we would want to go ahead and remove the setting. Now, what can we do once we have that information showing in Kudu? We can go into the local directory and see the files, thereby using this information to figure out where in our code may be writing to this space. And one last item that I want to point out is that there is a site extension for disk usage that can be installed from Kudu. We can go to the gallery. And scroll down until we see Azure Web Apps Disk Usage Site Extension. Once installed, this will actually list the size of each of your folders in that diagnostics console. Or debug console, however you would like to phrase it. So instead of just seeing the individual file sizes, you'll have folder sizes. This is activated by just restarting your application. And if we just go on back over to site extensions, you'll notice that it's already installed, so it's pretty fast. The reason why I wanted to tell you about this extension is that while it is great for pinpointing and understanding which components of your site are consuming disk space, it does have a limitation of listing the information for only the home directory. Due to this, it would not be used when troubleshooting temporary storage issues. However, I still wanted to mention it as it is useful for other disk space issues your application may be facing. But to conclude, that's how you can go about troubleshooting temporary storage issues. And I hope that this information helps some of you understand this section of the file structure a little bit more. Bye, everyone.